Hello everyone, thank you for watching and subscribing to my channel. I want to give you guys a few tips, 10 things to look for when buying a used vehicle. First thing what you want to do is start with a Carfax report, because Carfax report will give you some basic understanding in terms of history on the vehicle. Maintenance, has the car been flooded before, wrecked before? Carfax will not show you or give you all the details. We'll give you some details. The details you find in the Carfax report are basically things that people reported through either it was police involved, either at a dealership was involved, or insurance was involved. So is the Carfax report the most accurate? Well, there's other agencies that provide history for the vehicle. Most of the dealers use Carfax report. If you buy it from the private owner, what you can do, you can get a VIN number and purchase that report and see what's on that report. Are there any gaps? You know what I mean? Because you want to look at a VIN number on a vehicle and then match the Carfax report. Because if there is a gap, you want to ask yourself, what is it? Has the car been stolen before? Are the VIN numbers has been changed before? Things of that nature. So that's the first thing you want to look at it. Carfax report. Because was the car rental? Because you want to know what you're buying. You know what I mean? If dealer cannot provide you a car report, Carfax report, we might want to consider buying it yourself. You know, get a VIN number and get it. Second thing, look for the signs of painting. Has the car been painted before? You know, because it would not show up on the Carfax report. Like I said, things that don't show on the Carfax report. For example, someone was driving and hit the curb. They took their car to the small body shop, got repaired. It would not show up on the Carfax report or any other reports, because it did not go through the insurance and the police was not involved with it. So that's the reason why. And the big dealership was not involved. So not everything will show up on a Carfax report. Like this car that I'm looking at right now. Carfax report did not show any, it was clean, had clean title, clean Carfax, didn't show any accidents. But here is the thing, bubbles. Not sure if the camera can pick it up, there is bubbles. Yes, on the Carfax report, it did not show the windshield was replaced. But around the edges on the windshield, you can see that it was replaced. And before I purchased this vehicle, I went to the dealer. It was a certified dealer, was selling a certified car, but it was repainted. Paint did not match 100%. Bubbles around the windshield. That's the one thing. VIN number, where to get the VIN number? The VIN number is at the bottom right there, and when you open the door, there is a VIN number up there too. So there is many locations. You wanna make sure when you buy the car, they're the same thing and not different. So paint, windshield, bubbles around windshield, make sure there is no signs of it was repainted. If it is, you wanna know why. Look underneath the vehicle. Any rust, body plugs if missing. So let's see if the camera can pick it up. I'm using my phone for the body plugs. Plugs are missing, and I have a video. I will post a link in this description. It means the car either was stolen and they had to remove so they can hook up their hooks, or if the body plugs are missing, maybe it wasn't a light flood. Water got inside the vehicle and they wanted to drain between the frame rails and they never put them back. And if the body plugs are missing, it means water can get there, salt, and will corrode, and your car will not last as long as you think it should. So that's the third thing, to look for the rust, body plugs, if anything is missing. You know, look at the exhaust in the back, is it rusted, things of that nature. You know what I mean? That's the third thing. Fourth thing, look for the oil leaks underneath the vehicle. So here is the front of the vehicle, there is an engine, there is a transmission up there. Go in the front of the vehicle. I'm not sure if the camera will pick it up or not, but I'll try. We'll see. It's not the best phone camera. So there you go. Look underneath for any signs of any oil leaks. That's the fourth thing. If there is signs, you know what I mean, that means you would have to be, that would have to be fixed either by the dealer, owner, or if you want to take it and do it yourself and spend the money. When there is oil leaks, that means either car wasn't maintained or was maybe was abused. So you gotta know up front before you buy it. 15, look underneath the hood for oil leaks and maybe possible water pump. See this liner underneath the hood? What is it? Yeah, the liner. So here is the belt. And if the water pump is leaking, or oil is leaking somewhere on the side of the engine, you will see a line. You will see a line either here or the other side or somewhere here. You will see a line. It's, you cannot, you know what I mean? It's something that's very visible. If there is anything leaking, either the water pump is leaking bad enough or the oil is leaking from the crankshaft and from the seals or somewhere from the engine, you will see the line. You will see underneath and you will see the line. That's something. Even though if the dealership or the private owner or the dealer, whoever washes the engines, they, I know they do wash the engines, clean them before people buy them, buy the vehicle. So that's one. That's the 15. Or is it 15? Yes, that's the 15. Sixth thing you want to look before buying a car. Pull the oil cap. Pull the oil cap. Because the oil cap will tell you a lot of things. Make sure the car is cold or use the rag. You don't want to burn yourself. And why oil cap? Because oil cap will tell you a lot of things. How the car was maintained. Not sure if you can see in the camera inside the cap. There should not be any buildup. If there is a buildup, you cannot see, there is usually numbers or something, markups. Then you know the car was not maintained well. Other thing, inside. The engine should be clean. If the engine is clean, it means the vehicle was maintained, oils were changed on a regular basis. The cap itself, dealer can replace or even wash on inside. So cap is, you know what I mean, what I noticed when people watch my videos, they'll go ahead and do it, you know what I mean? So there will be dealers who will, after watching my video, will start cleaning the caps. So people can think they're getting themselves a deal. See the engine inside? See the oil, and then you see the metal. If the metal is clean, has no varnish, no discoloration, it means the vehicle was maintained and oil was changed on a regular basis. So this is the sixth thing. Other thing, transmission. If the transmission, so when you're looking at the car, the sixth thing, one of the six things to look before buying it is check engine oil dipstick. Pull it out, they're usually yellow color handle, and check the oil color and see what color. If it's milky color like coffee with cream, then there is a problem with the head gasket, there is something with it, you know. Or if it's black, that means hasn't been changed. So also, if transmission has a dipstick, will be similar yellow, maybe red. If there is a transmission dipstick, pull it out the dipstick and see what exactly the color of the fluid, transmission fluid. Because I have seen one of the cars that I was ready to purchase from the owner. He told me the transmission was rebuilt, right, just fresh. When I looked at fluid, the fluid was pitch black, like the color you see right there, the plastic color, yeah. So that means he was lying to me, it wasn't rebuilt. There was any sign when I look at the transmission, they was pulled or rebuilt, it was dirty, covered with dust, so there was no way, dirt. So that's seventh thing to look at it. Coolant, engine coolant, that's something you want to look. In this car, it's, she makes sure there is an engine coolant there. You know what I mean? Pull the cover off, like the little cap, or in some cars, it's hard to see because of the sun and the shade. Check the coolant level, if there is anything. If there is no coolant, there is a problem. Either head gasket is blown, or the water pump is leaking. So that's something to look at it, you know. The 17 is make sure the coolant level. If it's possible to, you know, if it's not enclosed too much with the plastic like in this car, check the color of the coolant. See if it's has any oil in it, or you know what I mean, looks kind of strange. Just question in attitude. Just ask, you know. That's the 17. 18, check the door seals for any signs, for any moisture. And let me show you what I mean, door seals. These are the door seals that I'm talking about. Check, pull them off. See if there is any signs of maybe the car was flooded, you know what I mean? Sand, dirt, anything. Same thing up there. You wanna check that something easy to do it. Quick check just to see, to be safe, to be on the safe side, the car wasn't flooded before. That's 18. Tires. Yes, you wanna check the tires. You wanna turn the steering wheel to one side, to other side, and check the tread of the tires. See if there is any sign the tires are not wearing out evenly. Maybe the alignment. Maybe the car was in an accident before, wasn't fixed properly, and it's not disclosed anywhere on a Carfax report or anything, you know what I mean? You would wanna know up front before you sign the papers and, you know, buy yourself a headache, a problem. The 19, tires for an even wear size. Our wheels are oversized. Is the car lowered, you know, or any of those things? Just want to look at it and see if it something looks fishy, funny about the tires, about the size. Maybe the car is lowered. That's the 19th to look at it. And the tenth thing to look at it in a car is interior. Get inside the car and see if you can pick up a smell, you know what I mean? If there is any smell of... So the interior of the vehicle, check it out and see, sit down, and if there is a smell of any moisture, any, maybe a dead mouse or anything, you know what I mean? You want to smell, see if it smells, hasn't been flooded, or has anything been burned, you know what I mean? Things of that nature. That's what you want to check. Check, that's the 10th thing to look for. Check every single component, power windows, power locks, check each window. If there is a sunroof, check the sunroof. Because you want to be on the safe side. You want to make sure everything is working the way it's supposed to work. You don't want to be caught by surprise. And once you go through this checklist, you know what I mean, and you find that, yeah, everything looks the way it is and I'm okay with it, go for a test drive. Because the car that I looked at one, that was had repainted and bubbles around the windshield, because those bubbles means windshield was replaced and possibly it was not sealed properly. My brother purchased a car from a dealer, certified car with a warranty. 6 months later, to find out, he was getting water inside his car. He couldn't figure out why. He spent countless time trying to find out. Later, he found out that windshield was replaced, it wasn't properly sealed, and he had water inside his car. So right there, you know, and there's an example to look at those things is, has it been replaced? Hasn't been, what was done to it before? You know, you gotta look at those every little detail. So, and last thing, test drive it. See if the car, how's it drives, you know what I mean? Warm it up. Does the car overheats? Is air conditioning working? Is everything working in the car? And those are the things, you know, and if you have a question, ask me. Don't forget to subscribe. Don't forget to click that little bell.